we are monitoring the status of four loads, namely load 1, load 2, load 3, and load 4. As you can see, currently all of the loads are off. So let's turn them on one by one. As soon as we click on load 1, the data is sent to our circuit and the load turns on. Similarly, other loads can be operated as well.
So we will now first study how the project is made. To check that, we will first go to neonprojects.com. So once you reach the website, you can just go to any category page or click on any particular project, and then in the search you have to type the project name. So I'll make a search for IoT circuit, and this is the project here. So this is the IoT circuit breaker project. To check the explanation, we have to scroll down here to the block diagram. So as you can see, this is the block diagram. This is the at mega controller. This is the Wi-Fi module. The Wi-Fi module is used with the controller to connect to the internet over IoT using your Wi-Fi connection. And for the IoT part, we use IoT Gecko, which is an IoT development platform online. It's a free platform online. And then this is the octocoupler and triac circuit. This is used to control the loads for switching off individual loads using the controller. And this is the LCD display, used to display whatever we want, like the status of circuit breaker and status of the system. And as you can see, this is the power supply. We'll study this in detail in the circuit creation or circuit designing section, which is coming up in the video. And to sum up the block diagram, the way it works is the IoT system is used to connect to the controller through Wi-Fi module. The Wi-Fi module is an ESP8266 module, which serves as a connection point between the controller and the IoT system. And the controller is the brain of the system, which takes command from the IoT system and instructs the octocoupler, provides signals to the octocoupler and triac system so that the proper load can be switched as per the circuit breaker instructions. So after this, we will move on to the component section. So these are the various components used in the project. As you can see, the ATmega328 AVR microcontroller, the ESP8266 Wi-Fi module, crystal oscillator, which is used to, you know, used to generate a frequency required for the controller, LCD display, and all these components have links with them. Okay, I'll show you in some time. And this is the software specification. Software includes the language which is used for programming the controller, and we use C language here. And the compiler that is used is Arduino compiler. And IoT Gecko is the software system used for the IoT part. It is an online platform. And so let's check the controller here. So the controller details are given here. This is the ATmega328 controller, and you can find the details of the controller here. This is the overview features, and you can find the detailed, very, you know, minute details of the controller here. That is the pin diagram and pin description of individual pins. And also there's a video tutorial here for your reference if you want to study the controller. Because to make the project, you will need to study all the components that are used in the system. So let's go back here and let's check the Wi-Fi module. Similarly, this is the Wi-Fi module here, the details and its overview, and this detail, pin detail of it, and interfacing diagram. So, and along with that, LCD, crystal oscillator, everything is there. In this project, let me see. In this project, we have used a 16:2 LCD. So if you want to make this particular one, if you want a larger display, you can select the 20:2 one, this one here. And also the LEDs needed in the system are available here. And whichever color you want, you can customize the system by LED size, the LCD display size, the LEDs that you want. And also other LCD and TFT displays are available. Also LED dot matrix display can be used here, depending on what you want to, you know, how you want to customize it. Then we'll come back here. And as you can see, everything that you need from transformer to the PCB, it's all here. The PCB is, it all starts with the PCB. The PCB is like the base of the system. And to make this system, you can use a 6x6 PCB. And this is a, this one is a good quality PCB, the copper clad one. If you want to go a little bit lower quality, you can go for this one. A larger size available in this copper clad. And also the etching powder, which you will be needing to etch the PCB or print the PCB once you have the layout. So these are the components and the overall block diagram explanation here. So now we'll move on to the circuit development and coding section to study it in detail. So now let's study the circuit diagram development of this project. तो अब जो है हम इस प्रोजेक्ट के सर्किट डायग्राम डेवलपमेंट पे फोकस करेंगे. सो टू स्टार्ट विद द सर्किट डायग्राम, वी विल फर्स्ट सिलेक्ट अ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर. सबसे पहले हम माइक्रो कंट्रोलर सिलेक्ट करेंगे. सो दिस इज अ एटमेगा बेस्ड प्रोजेक्ट, सो विल सिलेक्ट द एटमेगा माइक्रो कंट्रोलर फर्स्ट. सो वी आर यूजिंग प्रोटीएस फॉर सर्किट डिजाइनिंग. देयर आर अ वाइड वैरायटी ऑफ टूल्स इन द मार्केट, इंक्लूडिंग कीकैड, ईगल. सो if you use any tool, the GUI is different, but the procedure will be the same. Market में जो है काफ़ी सारे tools available है circuit बनाने के लिए. उनका GUI अलग अलग है, मतलब screen अलग होगा, लेकिन procedure same है. तो ये जो है हमने microcontroller select किया, Atmega 328. इसके बाद हम, so now we will add some resistors and transistors in the circuit. तो अब जो है हम कुछ रेजिस्टर्स और ट्रांजिस्टर ऐड करके दिखाएंगे इसमें. तो इस तरह से जो है आपको कीवर्ड में नाम डालना होता है. तो ये जो है हमने एक रेजिस्टर ऐड किया. अभी हम इसको लिंक करेंगे कंट्रोलर के साथ. जैसे आपको कोई भी पिन लिंक करनी हो तो आप इस तरह से जो है सो दिस हाउ वी यू नो वी लिंक अ कंपोनेंट टू अनदर कंपोनेंट. So now let's add a power supply to the controller.
So now we have added the components. Now we will start linking them. तो अब जो है हमने components add कर दिए, अब हम उन्हें link करेंगे. So as you can see, we just created a power supply for the Atmega controller. तो अभी हमने जैसे एक power supply पूरा create किया इस controller के लिए, इसी तरह से हम sensors और बाकी components है वो भी link कर सकते हैं. In the same way, we can link sensors as well as other components like buzzers, LCD and you know other sensors to the controller. So now let's delete this extra diode that we the resistor that we used here. So once this is done, now we can create a layout for this PCB. अब हम इस PCB के लिए layout बनाएंगे, जिस layout के जरिए हम PCB को print कर सकते हैं. So now let's go to this tab here, PCB layout. So before this we have to solve some errors. It shows us the errors here. ये जो है हमें errors बताता है, ये हमें solve करने होंगे. तो हम error को जो है solve करते हैं और फिर PCB बनाते हैं. So now in the layout section, we have to take those components into layout now. Let's create the PCB layout here. So abhi jo hai hum components ko PCB layout mein lenge aur layout banayenge yahan pe. ये जो है उन कंपोनेंट के पिन्स है, तो उसके हिसाब से जो है लेआउट बनता है. सो द कंपोनेंट पिन्स आर अवेलेबल हियर एंड ट्रैक्स बिटवीन देम. सो दिस इज हाउ अ पीसीबी लेआउट इज बिल्ट. सो नाउ द कंपोनेंट वंस द कंपोनेंट्स आर अरेंज्ड हियर, एक बार हम कंपोनेंट्स को अरेंज कर लेते हैं उसके बाद हम ट्रैक बनाएंगे उसके.
So this is how the tracks are created. इस तरह से हम tracks बनाते हैं PCB के, और इसको हम export करके हम जो है PCB को print कर सकते हैं.
So now this project has been programmed in C language and it uses Arduino compiler as we saw on the website. So let's start the Arduino compiler here. तो ये project जो है ये Arduino compiler में code हुआ है. तो इसके लिए हम Arduino compiler शुरू करेंगे. तो कंपाइलर में इसका जो कोड है वो हम पहले कंपाइल करते हैं. कंपाइलेशन से हमें पता चलता है कि कोड एरर फ्री है. तो इस तरह से जो है डन कंपाइलिंग यहां पे लिखा हुआ आता है. सो दिस इज हाउ द कोड इज कंपाइल्ड. एंड आफ्टर दैट व्हेन यू अटैच आर्डुइनो टू दिस then we can burn this code into whichever Arduino is attached here, and the Arduino controller at Mega can be programmed this way. So this is how it is programmed here from Arduino compiler.
Hi guys, and welcome to the demonstration of IoT based circuit breaker. This is an innovative system which can be used to control loads over the internet. This system is very useful when one needs to monitor and change the status of loads from a different room. Now, it can all be done at the click of a button. The system is powered by an Atmega 328 microcontroller. It boosts an LCD display and a Wi-Fi module. So, let's power it on. Our system is getting connected to the website using Wi-Fi. The system is now online. We are monitoring the status of four loads, namely load 1, load 2, load 3 and load 4. As you can see, currently all of the loads are off. So let's turn them on one by one. As soon as we click on load 1, the data is sent to our circuit and the load turns on. Similarly, other loads can be operated as well. Now, let's turn them off one by one. The system has an additional feature for changing the password as well. In this way, the password can be changed and the system can be secured. So, this is how the project works. Thank you.